وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى he said in the Quran الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم لو ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. This ayah is known as Ayatul Kursi. There are many virtues that have come regarding Ayatul Kursi. Many ahadith have spoken about the virtues of Ayatul Kursi. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention one of those narrations. And that is the hadith of Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. You can find this hadith in Sahih Muslim. Ubay radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, anna al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet said, Ya Aba al-Mundir, Abu al-Mundir, atadri ayu ayatin min kitab Allahi ma'aka a'zamu. Do you know the greatest verse of Allah with you? The greatest verse in the Quran that is with you? Qala qultu, I said, Abu al-Mundir, Ubay ibn Ka'b, he said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger know. Qala, the Prophet then said, Ya Aba al-Mundir, atadri ayu ayatin min kitab Allahi ma'aka a'zamu. Do you know what verse from the book of Allah is the greatest that is with you? Ubay then, this is the second time the Prophet asked him. Ubay then he said, قُلْتُ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّمُ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّمُ Ayatul Kursi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ubay answered the question, the Prophet فَضَرَبَ فِي صَدْرِ, the Prophet hit his chest. He hit the chest of who? Ubay. وَقَالَ, and the Prophet said, لِيَهْنِكَ الْعِلْمُ أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ لِيَهْنِكَ الْعِلْمُ أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ. What does that mean? The word لِيَهْنِكَ الْعِلْمُ in مِرْعَاتُ الْمَفَاتِيحِ Al-Mubarakafuri, he says, it means أَيْ لِيَكُنِ الْعِلْمُ هَنِيئًا لَكَ. Let knowledge be easy for you. Something that you can easily digest and take in, and simple. Also, the famous hadith that many of you will know of, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, وَكَلَنِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the Prophet, he placed me responsible sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bihifdhi zakati ramadan, to take care of the zakat of ramadan. Fa atani atin, a person came to me. Fa ja'ala yahthu min at-ta'am, he started to take from the food. There's a person who came, I was told to look after the zakat al-fitri, okay, zakat ramadan, I was told to look after it. A man came walking and he started to steal from the food. Fa akhadtu Abu Hurairah, said, I grabbed him. وقلت أنا, I said to him, والله لا أرفع عنك إلى رسول الله, I'm going to take you to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال he then, he said, إني محتاج, I'm a person in need. وعلي عيال, I have children. ولي حاجة شديدة, and I have a severe need. فخليت عنه, I let him go. Some people use this tactic. They love to use this guilt tactic. They use this to people. They play the victim syndrome. Oh, I've been wrong. People have done me bad. Some people love to do that. And that gets to some people, so they become soft and they just let go. So that's what he said. He said, إِنِّي مُحْتَاجٌ, I'm in need. وَعَلَيَّ عِيَالٌ, and I have children. وَلِي حَاجَةٌ شَدِيدَةٌ, and I have a severe need. Now that doesn't justify your stealing, by the way. A lot of people think the concept of entitlement, because I'm in this situation, I'm entitled for this. No, you're not. you're in this situation, you do need help, but go about it in the right way. So this is a shaytan, the way he takes. Okay? فَخَلَّيْتُ عَنْهُ I let him go, Abu Huraira said. Because Abu Huraira felt soft, he didn't know who this person was, so he let him go. فَأَصْبَحْتُ In the morning when I woke up, فَقَالَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Prophet said to me, يَا أَبَا هُرَيْرَ أَبُو هُرَيْرَ مَا فَعَلَ أَسِيرُكَ الْبَارِحَةَ What did your captive do yesterday? The one you grabbed, what did he do yesterday? قُلْتُ I said to him, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ That individual you're talking about, شَكَ حَاجَةً شَدِيدَةً وَعِيَالًا What he basically did was, he complained to me about his need and he has children and etc. فَرَحِمْتُهُ I became very merciful towards him. فَخَلَّيْتُ سَبِيلَهُ And I let him go. قال he then said, أَمَا إِنَّهُ قَدْ كَذَبَكَ This individual lied to you. وَسَيَعُودُ And he will return back. فَعَرَفْتُ أَنَّهُ سَيَعُودُ Abu Huraira now knew, he said, I knew he's going to come back. Because the Prophet told me, I knew he was going to come back. لِقَوْلِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ إِنَّهُ سَيَعُودُ فَرَصَدْتُهُ I hid for him. I was waiting for him. Okay, he's going to come. فَجَاءَ يَحْثُ مِنَ الطَّعَامِ And he came again, same thing. He came to the food again. He started to take from the food. فَأَخَذْتُ I grabbed him by the hand. فَقُلْتُ I said to him, لَأَرْفَعَنَّكَ إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ I'm going to take you to the Prophet. And then he said again, دَعْنِي, please let me go. فَإِنِّي مُحْتَاجٌ I'm in need. وَعَلَيَّ عِيَالٌ I have children. لَا أَعُودُ I will never come back. فَرَحِمْتُهُ I let him go. فَخَلَّيْتُ سَبِيلَهُ I said, you can go now. Go, go. فَأَصْبَحْتُ The morning came. فَقَالَ لِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ The Prophet said to me again, يَا أَبَا هُرَيْرَ أَبُو هُرَيْرَ مَا فَعَلَ أَسِيرُكَ What did your captive do? What did the man, you grabbed, what did he do? قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ شَكَى حَاجَةً شَدِيدَةً وَعِيَالًا He complained about his children that he has, and he complained about him being in the state of poverty, and he complained that he has children. He said, I'm doing all of this because of my kids. فَرَحِمْتُ I became soft again. فَخَلَّيْتُ سَبِيلَهُ And I let him go. The Prophet then said to you, إِنَّهُ كَذَبَكَ He lied to you again. وَسَيَعُودُ He'll come back again. فَرَسَدْتُهُ الثَّالِثَةَ Now this is another thing we learn about brothers and sisters, thieves and robbers. They get away with it once, that's it. It's hard for them to stop it now. Once they get away with it, they always think they're going to get away with it. And they keep doing it and doing it and doing it. So he got away with it first time, second time. He thought he was going to get away with it third time. Abu Hurairah said, I waited for him. فَجَاءَ يَحْثُ مِنَ الطَّعَامِ He started to do the same thing, started to take from the food. فَأَخَذْتُ I grabbed him. And then I said to him, لَأَرْفَعَنَّكَ إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ I'm going to take you to the Prophet of Allah. وَهَذَا آخِرُ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتٍ This is the last of three. تَزْعُمُ You claim لَا تَعُودِ That you're not going to come back. ثُمَّ تَعُودِ And you keep coming back. دَعْنِي Leave me. أُعَلِّمُكَ كَلِمَاتٍ This individual said to him, let me go, please. I will teach you something. And Abu Huraira really loved knowledge. Really loved knowledge. So far, Abu Huraira doesn't know who this individual is. He doesn't know who he is. So Abu Huraira, what does he say? Abu Huraira, he responds and he says, what is it? ما هو? What is it that you're going to teach me? قال, he said to him, إِذَا أَوَيْتَ إِلَى فِرَاشِكَ If you come to your bed, when you go to your bed, فَقْرَ آيَةَ الْكُرْسِي Recite آيَةَ الْكُرْسِي اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّمُ Read it. حَتَّى تَخْتِمَ الْآيَةَ Until you complete the verse. هَا فَإِنَّكَ لَا يَزَالُ عَلَيْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَافِظٌ You'll be protected by just reciting this verse. وَلَا يَقْرَبَنَّكَ شَيْطَانٌ حَتَّى تُصْبِحْ Shaytan will not come to you until the morning. فَخَلَّيْتُ سَبِيلَهُ I let him go. فَأَصْبَحْتُ The morning came. فَقَالَ لِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Prophet said to me, مَا فَعَلَ أَسِيرُكَ الْبَارِحَةَ What did the captive, the man you grabbed, what did he do last night? قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ يَا مَسْجِدُ اللَّهِ زَعَمَ أَنَّهُ يُعَلِّمُونِ He claimed that he's going to teach me some words, كلمات يَنْفَعُنِ اللَّهُ بِهَا فَخَلَّيْتُ سَبِيلَهُ He told me that he's going to teach me some words that will benefit me. The Prophet then said to him, مَا هِيَ What did he teach you? قال he said to me إذا أويت إلى فراشك if you come to your bed فقر آية الكرسي recite آية الكرسي من أولها حتى تختم he said to me start آية الكرسي read from the beginning to the end الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وقال لي he also said to me لن يزال عليك من الله حافظ this ayah Allah will protect you by reciting it ولا يقربك شيطان will not come close to you حتى تصبح until the morning وكان أحرص شيء على الخير And Abu Huraira was well known for his striving to all good. He loved knowledge. Ilm was something he loved. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, أَمَّا إِنَّهُ قَدْ صَدَقَكَ The Prophet, he said, he told you the truth. وَهُوَ كَذُوبٌ but he's a liar. Compulsive liar. تَعْلَمُ مَنْ تُخَاطِبُ Do you know who you were speaking to for منذ ثلاث ليالي, those three nights? أبا هريرة. Do you know who it was? قَالَ لَا أَبُو هُرَيْرَةَ I didn't know. I don't know who it was. The Prophet then said to him, ذَاكَ شَيْطَانٌ That's a shaitan. Now some people, after reading this story, they took a misconception from it. They took a wrong understanding from it. And that is, they said that you're allowed to take knowledge from someone who's corrupt. You can take knowledge from a corrupt individual. You can go and benefit from a mubtadi' and go take knowledge from him. That's what they took from the hadith. First of all, we say that the hadith, it doesn't support that notion. It doesn't. Why? Number one, shaitan did not know who it was. So you're telling a person he's an innovator, but go to him. The person knows who he's going to is an innovator. Shaitan, Abu Huraira didn't know that this was shaitan. That's number one. The second thing is that Abu Huraira didn't accept the information he got from this person until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam agreed to it. After the Prophet told him that this individual told you the truth, but he's a compulsive liar, only then did Abu Huraira accept this. Because look at the Abu Huraira, you can tell from how Abu Huraira put forward the statement of shaitan, that he didn't accept it from him. How? He said, za'ama, he claimed. Abu Huraira said, he claimed, when he spoke to me, he claimed that he said to me, that if you recite Ayatul Kursi. And the word za'ama, brothers and sisters, what does it show? The scholars, they say za'ama is matiyatul, it's za'ama matiyatul kadib. Za'ama is a what? Matiyatul kadib, as the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Za'ama alladhina kafaru, alla yub'athu, qul bala wa rabbi la tub'athuna, thumma la tunabba'una bima amiltum, adharika ala Allah yaseer. Za'ama is when you say that they claimed. Okay? They claimed. So Abu Huraira was trying to say, "Za'ama annahu yu'allimuni." He claimed that he was going to teach me. He didn't accept it from him. He only accepted it when the Prophet said. Also, brothers and sisters, taking knowledge from an innovator, a corrupt person, and saying, "I'm going to take the good that he has and I'm going to leave the good bad." First of all, two responses. The first response is, as a student of knowledge, who's learning, how do you know what's right and what is wrong? How do you know what he's saying is wrong? And how do you know what is right? If you're a beginner student of knowledge, or if you're an intermediate student of knowledge, how would you know what your teacher is saying is right or what is wrong? How would you know if you haven't studied before? Does that make sense? And if you then say, no, I can tell the difference, then are you actually a student of knowledge or should you be the teacher? Okay? The second one is that, brothers and sisters, it actually goes against the relationship a student should have with his teacher. The student of knowledge should have to trust his teacher and take what his teacher says, and believe in his teacher's information. A student shouldn't live his life by saying, okay, he's got that right. Oh, he's got that wrong. The poet, he said, إِذِ الْفَتَى حَسْبَ اعْتِقَادِهِ رُفِعْ وَكُلُّ مَا لَمْ يَعْتَقِدْ لَمْ يَنْتَفِعْ If you don't trust your teacher so much, so that whatever his aqidah, if you don't trust him, why are you sitting with him for? Why? You're doubting someone, but you want to, that goes against the relationship a student should have with his teacher. So it sounds very robotic from some people. They just repeat what they heard somewhere else. Take the good and benefit and get rid of, ignore the mistakes. No, it doesn't work like that. Go to someone who you take the good from them, okay? And when you grow up, the mistakes that your teacher would have, your teacher's not going to be infallible, of course, but they're not, points are going to destroy your aqidah or your relationship with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we spoke about the virtue of it. Let's talk about this verse. Why was it mentioned here? Allahu la ilaha illa al-hayyul qayyum. The relationship that it has with the verse before it. What is it? As you know, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he mentions the kuffar, the kafirin, that they are zalimun. Allah mentioned that they are criminals and that they transgressed and that they exceeded their limits. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we all know, bu'itha ila nasi kafa. The Prophet was sent to all of mankind. Okay? And the people that the Prophet ﷺ was directly dealing with was the Christians and the Jews, which were known as Ahlul Kitab, and Mushriki al-Arab, the Arab pagans. The Christians and the Jews, what did they do? In their shara'i', their legislations, and in their aqa'id, their beliefs, they innovated things in it. They added things in their legislations, which is the shara'i', and the aqa'id, which are their creedal beliefs. They've also introduced new things in their religion, and of course subtracted things from it. And they attributed to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ma la yajuzu alayhi, that which is not right. As for the Arab pagans, what did they do? They took idols, aliha, and then they started to worship these idols. So this great verse, Allahu la ilaha illahu al-hayyul qayyum, came about, which points out what? Ila ifradillahi bil-wahdaniyya, singling Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in worship. Okay? Also that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, from his great majestic characteristics, is al-haya, he's alive, which we're going to talk about inshaAllah ta'ala. And qayyumiyyatahu, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is يعني قائم بنفسه, that Allah stands for his own affairs. No one, he doesn't need anyone to help him. And he also stands for the affairs of his creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also this verse inshaAllah ta'ala, as we're going to see, the kingdom of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala encompasses the seven heavens and everything that is in it, the universe and everything that is in it. He owns it all, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also this teaches the concept that the kuffaru Quraysh and also the Christians and the Jews were pushing, which is intercession. No. Intercession is not given by anyone except Allah, unless Allah gives them permission, subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we're going to see. Also, giving this يعني, infinite knowledge to the creation. No. Infinite knowledge is only for who? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The ayah is talking to them and telling them these things. And that Allah is the only one who encompassed everything in knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Also, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has irada, and he does whatever he wills and how he wills and what he wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this verse, brothers and sisters, it really points out for us al-aqidah as-sahiha. Okay, which is mahdhu tawheed. It talks about the pure essence of tawheed. And to toss off tarhi ma siwaha, every other belief and every other filthy concepts that people have introduced, ignore it and focus on this. So let's go over it together inshallah ta'ala and reap the fruits and the benefits in it. First of all, Allah says, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, which means لا أحد معبود بحق, there is no person who deserves to be worshipped except Allah تبارك وتعالى. فهو وحده المستحق للعبادة, Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped, and he deserves to be worshipped حبا وتعظيما, he deserves to be worshipped alone in love and in glorification, سبحانه وتعالى. Why? لكمال صفاته, because of his complete characteristics that he has, and because he created us, سبحانه وتعالى, and because he deserves it, سبحانه وتعالى, he deserves it. As Allah said in the ayah in Surah Al-Hajj, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ, Allah is the haqq. وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرِ. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says in the next part, he says, الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّومِ. الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّومِ, what does it mean? It means Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, it's the one who has الْحَيَاةِ الْكَامِلَةِ. Allah has complete life. So what does that actually mean, الْحَيَاةِ الْكَامِلَةِ? It means لا يسبقها عدم ولا يلحقها زوال. لا يسبقها عدم ولا يلحقها زوال. This is what it means. It means Allah's life, it was never يعني, absent. There was not a time where Allah didn't exist. No. لا يسبقها عدم. There was never a time he didn't exist. No. ولا يلحقها زوال. And there won't come. There won't come a time where he won't exist as well. He always did exist. He does exist. And he lives, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will always carry on living, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? That's what it means when we say al-hayatul kamila. La yasbiquha adamun wa la yalhaquha zawal. And brothers and sisters, al-hayyul qayyum, it represents a type of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics, which is known as sifat al-dhatiyah. There are characteristics which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he always is. ما زال ولا لا يزال متصفا بها. لا يزال متصفا بها. There are characteristics that Allah always is. And those characteristics are called الصفات الذاتية. الصفات الذاتية. The representation of صفات الذاتية here is الحياة. الحياة here represents الصفات الذاتية. And all of صفات الذاتية go back to الحياة. And then we have the next one, which is Al-Qayyum. And Al-Qayyum represents what? As-sifat al-fi'liyya. As-sifat al-fi'liyya. What are sifat fi'liyya? Sifat fi'liyya are characteristics that are connected to Allah's mashi'ah. He does it when he wants and he doesn't do when he doesn't want to. Like a nuzul, for example. Allah descending subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last third of the night. That is a characteristic called as-sifat al-fi'liya. Allah does it when He wants. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-qayyum represents that. Because it means Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He stands for the creation and He helps and He's there for them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So al-hayat, what did we say? Al-hayat al-kamila, it means التي لا يسبقها عدم ولا يلحقها زوال. And then al-qayyum means what? القيوم بنفسه stands for his own self سبحانه وتعالى فلا يحتاج لأحد. Allah doesn't require anybody. القائم بأمور غيره, and Allah stands for the affairs of this creation. How? من الرزق والتدبير. Allah provides for us. Look what Allah said after He told us to worship Him. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says that He's the one who deserves to be worshipped alone, and that's why He created us, the jinns and the ins. That's why He created us. No other purpose to worship Him alone. And then look what after He says, ما أريد منهم من رزق. I don't want provision from them. And Allah doesn't want it from you. Allah doesn't want you to give to Him. سبحانه وتعالى. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah is the one who provides. Allah is the one who gives. Because He is what? القائم بنفسه فلا يحتاج لأحد. القائم بأمور غيره من الخلق من خلقه من الرزق. He is the one سبحانه وتعالى. Every موجودات, everything that exists around us today, they are in need of Him. مفتقرة إليه. They all need Him سبحانه وتعالى. لا قوام لها بدونه. They can't stand. وهذه القيومية, this قيومية shows Allah تبارك وتعالى all of His character, all of His actions are what? Complete. Pay attention here. So al-hayat shows Allah, all of His sifat are complete. And al-qayyum shows what? All of His actions, af'al, is complete, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah says in the ayah, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتِ. Rely on the one who is always alive and He never dies. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِهِ, and exalt Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, from the verse of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, are what? أن تقوم السماء والأرض بأمره. The samawat and the ard, the heavens and the earth, all of them stand. They stand with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's commands. Yani Allah controls it subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah then says, لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم is an explanation of what was mentioned before. Did we not just say Allah is al-hayy and al-qayyum? So من كمال حياته وقيوميته, from Allah تبارك وتعالى's complete حيات and from the complete قيومية of Allah تبارك وتعالى is that what? أنه لا يعتري سبحانه وتعالى نعاس ولا يغلبه نوم. Allah doesn't get نعاس. سنة and نعاس are the same. And Allah تبارك وتعالى doesn't feel sleepy or doesn't sleep سبحانه وتعالى. What does the word سنة mean? سنة is called مقدمة النوم. It's the beginning of sleeping. It's when you start going down like this, you slightly eyes closed and you wake up. Allah, none of that happens to it. وَلَا نَوْمٌ, and He doesn't sleep, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, for Him is what? مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. يعني إِنَّهُ يَمْلِكُ وَحْدَهُ جَمِيعَ مَا فِي الْكَوْنِ بِغَيْرِ نِدٍّ وَلَا شَرِيكٍ. Allah, He owns everything, okay, from this universe. بِغَيْرِ نِدٍّ وَلَا شَرِيكٍ, and there's no one who shares it with Him. There's not another creation or another being or another God that runs the universe with Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody, everything that you see are abidu, are His slaves. وَمَمْلُوكُونَ لَهُ, He owns them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا تَنْبَغِي الْعِبَادَةُ لِغَيْرِ لِهِ, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadah shouldn't be done for anybody other than Him. Allah then asks us a question. He says, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. This question is called a rhetorical question. It's a rhetorical question. Allah doesn't want you to answer it. The answer is already there. You just have to listen. Which is what? لا أحد يتجاسر على القيام بالشفاعة عند الله تعالى إلا بعد إذنه جل وعلا. No one has the audacity. No one has the power and the strength to intercede for anyone unless Allah gives them permission. This is a powerful way Allah, by asking the creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's asking the creation, but the answer is already in the question. It's a very eloquent way of putting it forward. is that you're being asked a question, so you pay attention, but then the answer's already in there. Istifamun inkari. Ay, la ahada yatajasar. No one has even the doubt, the ability and the strength to what? To stand up and to say, intercession. I'm going to do it for you. No. Illa ba'da idni subhanahu wa ta'ala, unless Allah gives them permission, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya'lamu, he knows, ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ma bayna aydi khalqihi min al-umuri al-madiyati. Wa ya'lamu aydan, he knows, ma khalfahum min al-umuri al-mustaqbala. Allah knows the future, he knows the present. He knows all brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows, ya'lamu ma kana, he knows what has happened. مَا سَيَكُونُ, that which is going to happen in the future. He knows it as well. He knows what happened in the past. He knows what's going to happen in the future. وَمَا هُوَ كَائِنٌ, and that which is happening right now, he knows it. He even knows مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ لَوْ كَانَ كَيْفْ يَكُونُ. He knows that which hasn't happened. If it was to happen, the way it would happen, he knows it. As he said in the ayah, بَلْ بَدَى لَهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُخْفُونَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. Allah mentions it in that verse. That the day of judgment, some people are going to cry, Ya Rab, take us back to the universe. Oh Allah, take us back to the universe. That's what they're going to say. And they're going to weep. And they're going to beg for Allah's mercy. And they say, Ya Rab, we understood our mistakes. Please take us back to the dunya. Allah then says, Walau ruddu, if they were to be taken back to the universe, they would have what? They would have gone back to what they were doing, their crimes and their atrocities and their evil doings and their evil actions. They'll go back to that. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ, and they lie. How does Allah tabarak wa ta'ala say that when it hasn't happened? Because he knows what hasn't happened if it was to happen. And that's not going to happen, by the way. But he knows if he was to do that, how it would be. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-umur al-madiyah, that which has happened in the past. He knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he also knows what? Al-umur al-mustaqbalah, the things that are going to take place in the future. He knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. يعني إن سائر من دونه, everyone, everything besides him سبحانه وتعالى, they don't know, they have no knowledge. لا يعلمون من علم الله, they don't know from the knowledge of Allah تبارك وتعالى شيئا البتة, they don't know anything from it whatsoever. They don't know what is before in that happened in the past and that which is going to happen in the future. They don't have no knowledge of that. Human beings even forget what they were present. They forget it. They don't remember it. Okay? Let alone the future. Humans don't even know what's happening right now. وَلِذَلِكَ, that's why the poet, he said to us that the person, the time of the person is three. Something that has happened in the past, you can't really do anything about it. All you can do is ask Allah for forgiveness and repent. And things that are happening at this current moment, which you have strength over and ability, you can work and you can, now you have a chance. As for the future, Allahu A'lam. The poet, he said, مَا مَضَى فَاتْ وَالْمُؤَمَّلُ غَيْبُ وَلَكَ السَّاعَةُ الَّتِي أَنْتَ فِيهَا. What has happened in the past has happened in the past. And the future is yet to come. Allahu A'lam if the future is going to come. If you're going to live to see the future. It might come, but you know, who said you're going to be there? مَا مَضَى فَاتْ, what has happened in the past has happened in the past. وَالْمُؤَمَّلُ غَيْبُ, and that which is in the future, you're hoping for it. وَلَكَ السَّاعَةُ الَّتِي أَنْتَ فِيهَا, you only own and you have ability and strength over what you're living in right now, this moment. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah تبارك وتعالى, His kursi has, subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's so vast and so big. It covers, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as-samawat wal-ard. It's even bigger than it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the kursi, brothers and sisters? The kursi is huwa mawdi'u qadamay rabbi azza wa jal. It's the place where Allah places His foot, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, he mentions, he said, al-kursiyu mawdi'u al-qadamayni. The kursi is the place of Allah's two foot. Wal-arshu la yaqdiru ahadun. And the arsh, لا يقدر أحد قدره. No one can know its ability. ولا يؤذه حفظهما. What does it mean? ولا يؤذه حفظهما. أي لا يثقله. There's nothing that's hard on him. ولا يشق عليه. And it's not even hard on him. حفظ السماوات والأرض. For Allah to protect the heavens, seven heavens and seven earth. It's not. Rather, all of that is what? سَهَلٌ عَلَيْهِ وَيَسِيرٌ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَهُوَ He is Allah تبارك وتعالى الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ Allah is Ali. And this is a contradiction for the Mu'tazila and the Jahmiyyah and the Asha'ira وَمَنَّحَا نَحْوَهُمْ and anyone who treads on their path who only affirm for Allah عُلُوَّ قَدْرٍ وَعُلُوَّ قَهْرٍ but they don't want to affirm for Him عُلُوَّ ذَاتٍ And the ayah is unrestricted. Allah says, وَهُوَ الْعَلِي And when we say Allah is Al-Ali, we say all three. Because Al-Ali here is unrestricted. Allah has the three types of ulu. Ulu dhatin. He, Allah, is above His throne. Ulu wa qadrin. Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, His status is higher than all of the creation and everyone. Ulu wa qahrina. It means He has power and saytara, strength over everyone. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that this is ulu mutlaqa, unrestricted ulu. So if someone says, no, the ulu here is not mutlaqa, it's restricted. Hey, بالدليل. Give us evidence. So this ulu is ulu mutlaq. Allah is above His creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In three things, ulu dhatin, wa ulu qahrin, wa ulu qadrin, subhanahu wa ta'ala. All three of them. If someone says, no, it's not, I want to take one out. You have to bring your evidence for us. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ Every single thing, brothers and sisters, are what? حَقِيرٌ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ They are weak in the presence of Allah تبارك وتعالى. صَغِيرٌ بِنِسْبَةِ إِلَيْهِ They are small in comparison to Him. فَلَا شَيْءَ أَعْظَمَ مِنْهُ سُبْحَانَهُ There is nothing greater than Him. That's what Al-Azim. Allah has Al-Azamata Al-Mutlaqa. Just the same way He has Al-Ulu Al-Mutlaqa, He also has Al-Azamata Al-Mutlaqa. فِي ذَاتِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ وَسُلْطَانِهِ And it's funny because they contradict themselves here. When it comes to the ulu, they take out ulu dhatin. But then the azama also has the three as well. It has ulu azama to dhatin, and there's azama in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's qahr and qudra. Why have you accepted those three in azama, but not accepted those three in al-ulu? So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is fi dhatihi, He Himself is greater than the creation. In His Qadr and Qahr, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and every single thing, kullu ma siwa, everything besides Him is haqirun bayna yaday, it's weak in the presence of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. He is the greatest, the highest, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. That's the points I wanted to share with you all, inshallah ta'ala, regarding this powerful verse. There's many more things that could have been taken. I have actually made a video on Ayatul Kursi alone. It's on the YouTube channel. You can actually go and watch it in greater details. I spoke about it in more details. But this is only يعني, benefits here or there regarding the verse, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.